Okay, I'm back. Now that I'm a little bit more calm and I feel a tad bit better, I'm able to think more clearly. The things that I posted and stated in my video earlier, it's still the same, but I'm not like frustrated, I'm not irritated anymore, and I'm not mad at the process. I'm not upset with what should be that isn't. I'm human, like everyone else. I'm a mom. I want my kid to have the best. I desire for him to have what he needs as well as what he deserves. He has a loving home. However, I want him to have the other intricate parts as well. Love from both sides of his families. He have two families, the mother side and the father side. And when one side isn't pulling their weight and it affects my son, I kind of get upset and I have moments. I'm grateful that I'm able to kind of control negative things that may want to come out my mouth because I'm having a moment. Because it doesn't help anything, even though I'm being human, I'm being a mom, like a mama bear, but negativity doesn't win. So I've come a long way from that. It's been a few years, but still, I'm just glad I'm not that person or in that place per se anymore. I get a lot of, feedback from parents, single fathers as well. So I thank you guys even from the emails that you guys sent me this morning. I appreciate it. Yeah, I appreciate it. Because not only when I post it here, it goes like to another website that I have. That a lot of people view the videos on there as well. So yeah, parenting is the most difficult job in the world. I think so. If you're really hands-on as a parent, you would agree. It doesn't matter how many books Barnes and Nobles have on the shelves about parenting. It doesn't tell you how to parent your child, though, because your child is going through a multiplicity of things that the book may not cover. So you have to bend and grin it. How do you say it? Bend and grit it. Or I forget. What is the saying? I don't know. You just have to figure things out. With you and the Lord and trial and error, and just pray that you make more better decisions than wrong decisions. So, yeah. So, we just have to keep God at the forefront. And I keep turning my head because, I'm able to watch TV at my job. And Wendy Williams is on for her crazy self. But, yeah. Just had a moment, so just trust and pray and believe that each day shall get better. Each day will get better. As I'm growing, I'm praying that my son will also grow as well. I've always told him, you may not understand everything that I do, but you have to see that everything that I do, it's for your best interests. Even the times that when you don't agree with me, there's going to be times in the future you're not going to like me. You're going to be upset and you're not going to understand why. But if you look at my track record, if you look at my fruit, you'll see that it's for your benefit, it's for your good. And I always tell him when he's upset, do you trust me? He'll say with an attitude like, yeah, mom. Well, I'm saying no for a reason. I'm saying no for the benefit of you. And I always throw that back on him. Me saying like my fruit. How have I raised you? I have talks with him. Jared, how can I be a better mom? Jared, is there anything about me that you don't like? Do you think I fuss too much? Do you think I'm too hard on you? If so, in what areas? Why do you think I'm hard? That's how I talk to my son. I don't have a dictator household. It's a democracy with a splash of dictatorship because we don't give children the credit that they deserve. They have feelings and they have emotions and if you just talk with them, they'll share a lot of how they feel, and you can get a variety of answers if you take the time to sit and listen and talk with your children. They have a lot of things they would like to share. And I like to talk to him so much so he doesn't just walk around with so many things bottled up inside, and then like he flips out one day and then it's like, oh, well, I was going through all of this, and he's like naming like 20 things. Now, I can't make him talk, but I give him the opportunity and the comfortability to talk. It doesn't matter how bad it is. Just tell the truth. You know, if you robbed somebody, if you was in a fight, if you stole something, of course I'm going to cringe. But let's talk about what was going on that you had that mindset that you had to do these things. And then, like, let's work this out together so it doesn't happen again. But if you're not up front with me, then it's like a whole nother ball game. So yeah, parenting, like I said, it's the most difficult job I think in the world. God's blessed you with a gift to temporarily take care of his gift, which indeed is our children, and we are being conscious of making sure that we take care of the gift from God that he loaned to us, which is our kids. So, trying to do my best. I really am. Adults have sex. Babies come out of it. The babies don't ask to be here. If the mom chooses to keep the child, you have to just make do. I didn't ask to be here. You didn't ask to be here. But now that we're here, okay, God help us do what we need to do to maintain this life so you can be proud of us. So, yeah. Guess that's it. For now, alrighty, again, thank you for your time, for your listening ear, for this viewing audience, and just keep me lifted. I really appreciate it. Coleman family. Alright, God bless you guys. Have a good day. Bye-bye.